One of the most important tools for you to use to be a successful student is your Howard College email. Today, I'm going to walk you through getting logged in for the first time and some of the features available using your Howard College email. I'm going to start from the Howard College website, howardcollege.edu. And there's a couple of places and ways you can access your email from here. You can do the student drop down here, and you're going to hover over that and go to the left to email. Or you can scroll to the bottom of any of our Howard College website pages, and you'll find some quick links here for student email. Now, this is going to take you to Microsoft, and that sometimes throws people for a loop, and they get confused because they've been taken away from the Howard College website, but that is correct. The Howard College email is hosted through Microsoft 365, which is what gives you access to some of the other cool features we'll see in a minute. So it is going to take you to a Microsoft login page. So we're going to log in using your Howard College email. So that will be the username that you've used to log into Blackboard or MyHC or any of those services on campus. And then it's going to be at STU for student, howardcollege.edu. So we'll put your entire email address there, then click next. Then it's going to ask you for your password, and your password is going to be the same password that you've used across all of the platforms. So whether that is MyHC or you've used it in Blackboard, you're going to use that same password on all of those services, which also means that if you reset your password somewhere, you're going to have to reset that password everywhere. So when you reset it for your email, then when you go to log into Blackboard, it's going to change it. And same thing, if you change it because you got locked out of Blackboard, it's going to change it on your email. So anytime you change it, make sure you save that information so you can get into your other services later. So we're going to put in our password and hit sign in. And since this is the first time that I have ever used this email address to log in, it's going to tell us that the organization needs more information to keep your account secure. So we're going to click next and move on to the next page. It's going to take us to an authorization page. And this one kind of worries people too, because you see lots of notifications that can get a little scary. I'm going to zoom in on those for you a little bit. And all that it's asking you is to put in a phone number or an email address that you have access to. So if you're using a phone number, it needs to be one that can get text messages so that you can get an authentication code to verify that you are who you say you are. So I'm going to do a setup now for my phone. I'm going to select the United States, and then I'm going to put in the phone number that I want to receive text messages at. I'm going to tell it to text me. You could do call me as well, but I'm going to select to text me. So it's going to text me a number, that verification number. And when I get it, I'm going to put it in and verify. And so then you see my green check mark. That means that I've taken care of that one. You only have to do one of these. If you're concerned, if you're someone who you change your phone number, or maybe you're afraid of losing access to that phone number or something, and you want to have another backup, you can also put in an email, but it's not required. And then I'm going to hit finish when I've done what I want on that page. It's going to ask me if I want to stay in, stay signed in. Of course, that is relative to you and your situation, if you're on a private computer or not. And it's going to bring us to the Office 365. Now, this may vary a little bit depending on if Microsoft updates things between the time this video was made and you're seeing it. But you can click through these if you want to see the services that they have offered. You can get some more information there, or you can exit out of it. And it's going to take you kind of to a dashboard. And so from this dashboard, if you had recently done any documents or made anything, then you might have those files might be here easily accessible for you. But what we're going to look at is over on the left-hand side, as you can see, this says Office 365. And down the side, we have all of the different applications that you have access to. So using your Howard College email address, you now have access to Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, which we'll get to in a second, OneDrive, OneNote, SharePoint, Teams, and Sway. So the ones that are usually used by students the most are going to be Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, and maybe your OneDrive. So OneDrive is going to operate kind of like a Google Drive or a cloud place that you can save documents. So you have access to them all over the place. So if you don't have a computer that you have access to all the time, you can save your files here so that you can access them anywhere as long as you can log into your account. And then, of course, PowerPoint and Microsoft Word, Excel. While we're here, I'm going to also show you that over here on the right-hand side of the screen is you'll see this Install Office button. So if you do a drop-down, you can see how to download Office 365 apps or some other options if you need some other options. So you can also download the app version of these onto your computer. So if you have a laptop or a computer at home, you can download these on there and use them offline as well. So that's one of the best things. That means you don't have to pay for a Microsoft services on a new computer or something because you have access to them here through Office 365. So let's get over to Outlook, which is our email, which is the point of our video. If we click open Outlook, it's going to bring us to our email folder. As you can see, this is a brand new account, so I don't have any emails in there for me to read. But if we did, then they would pop up here in the inbox. You can see your sent folder. You can see new message up at the top, drafts, all of those things like you would in a regular email address. Let's give me just 1 second and I will send an email to this account and we'll see what it looks like when one pops into the email box. So this is a place that you should check often. Your professors may use this to send out important information about your classes, if there have been any changes. This is definitely where they're going to send information if there has been a change, like if class gets canceled, or if there's something that you need to do. Your instructors are always supposed to communicate with you via your Howard College email address. So you won't be receiving that information from financial aid, your instructors, anybody other than through your Howard College email. There's also other people like student life or academic advising that may send you information as well that will tell you about fun events that are happening on campus, or if there's going to be somebody from a university on campus to talk about transfers or something. You'll learn that information quickest by checking your Howard College email frequently. So as you can see, an email has come in. It's just a test email. So I can click on that. It's going to open up and you're going to be able to see the body of that email right there. I can reply, I can forward. All of that is very easy from your email. So it works pretty simple once you have got it set up and ready to go. If you have any questions or you're having issues getting into any of your systems, you can also check out on our Howard College website. If you go to students and email setup or password reset, if we click that one, it's going to bring you to this page that I'm already on, and it's going to give you some phone numbers on who you can call for assistance on your home campus. It also is going to give you information if you need some other step-by-step on how to get your username and how to use them, information about the access, setting up that authentication that we just talked about, and 24/7 password support options. I think the coolest option is this one right here. You can call this phone number any time of day, and it's an automated system. And as long as you have your student ID number and the last 4 digits of your social, and then have your birthday on hand just in case, you can go through those prompts and it will automatically reset your password for you. Remember, that will change it everywhere. Blackboard, email, all of those places if you change it using this system. And then if none of that is working or you need additional help, you can email blackboard@howardcollege.edu. Follow these instructions for providing them as much information as you can so that they can help you most efficiently. So that is about it for using your Howard College email, getting into it, getting your authentication set up. Again, you can access that by going to office.com or outlook.com directly. You can, from here, you can also access all of those apps from this little button in this area. We always recommend, if you can, you know, downloading it onto your phone or logging in as an Office 365 email address so that you always have access to it, checking it, you know, a couple of times a day or more throughout the week so that you know what is going on campus. If you have any questions, refer to that place on the website, and hopefully we can help you get those things straightened out.